This video is sponsored by the brand new JV Jiu-Jitsu online store at jvjiujitsu.bigcartel.com. What's going on, everybody? This is Javi Vasquez. Chapter 3, Turtle Top, and Chapter 5, Back Mount Offense, have a relationship. Both positions are based with the attacker's chest on the opponent's back, with the over-under position established from the attacker's perspective. From an offensive standpoint, Turtle Top is a position that has its limitations and its advantages. Strike-based Jiu-Jitsu follows three possibilities of attack and one transition that can occur in this position. The difference between Chapter 3 and Chapter 5 are in the hooks, or the lack thereof. One of the most common transitions from the turtle top position is to insert the hooks and take the opponent's back. In this video, I will discuss some of the principal hook insertion options from the turtle top position and the transition to the back mount position. As always, I hope you enjoy this content and thank you for watching.
Air cutters. Good job. Okay. So, striking next week, but we do turtle top this week. So, whenever you get the turtle top, usually it's off of a snap down or you circle behind the guy. First thing you're going to do is you're going to lock your hands, control. And at that point, there are four basic things that can happen. Three things I can attack, and then one thing that he can do that will land me in a different spot. So what can I attack? Well, if I'm in the turtle top position, I can choke his neck. But it is far more difficult to choke his neck without trapping his arm first. So one of the attacks that I'm going after, one of the things I'm going after, is I'm trying to trap his arm behind this. The next thing I can attack, I don't need to have that arm in order to attack his neck, so I attack the neck. Now attack the neck and trap the arm go hand in hand. They work together, and ultimately I will trap your arm. Once I trap your arm, guess what I'm going to get to? Get to your neck. I get to absolute advantage. Third thing I can attack is getting hooks in. That's the first thing that we're gonna deal with right now. Just getting hooks in, and then we'll worry about attacking your arm, and we'll worry about getting to the neck. Getting hooks in. The fourth thing that can happen, and I'm probably gonna cover it later in the week, is when they roll you over. You end up on your side, on your back. That's the fourth thing. So what we're gonna be trying to do first is get the hooks in. Now, how do I get the hooks in? Well, one real simple way to get the hooks in is I'm looking for space here. The more space there is here, the easier I can go through it. Pull hooks in. I can insert the second hook here or fall forward. Controlling the back here, I'm just trying to get the hooks in. Another way that I can do it, if this space is not available, is I pick him up. Boom. Simple. How am I picking him up? I just get to a squatting position. My chest is still on his back, my back foot is right near his feet, my front foot is right near his elbow. And now I'm just picking him straight up. I'm making space between the knee and the elbow. Poof, I set my foot inside of him. So I can attack it directly, or I can pick him up. Those are easy. what is he going to do in order to stop that? Well, he's going to use his elbows, he's going to use his hands. If I go to pick him up, he just stays heavy. So now comes the real battle, which is my knee against his arm. What I'm going to do is I'm going to slide my knee into this hole here. Now that hole will depend on how tight the elbow is in, and I'll get back to that here in a minute. What I'm looking to do is I'm looking to make space between the knee and the elbow, and then replace my knee with my other foot. So we're here, he's not that one inside there, so he's fairly snug here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start putting my knee high. He can close this pretty tight, but there's always a space if you go high at the hip. So I'm gonna go high at the hip. And now, just like I'm going on a slide, I slide down, as I pick up his elbow, I slide my knee to the left. So no matter how tight he is here, I just lean, look, lean back, right, knee forward, knees forward. Now, what you need to understand is that there is a relationship between my knee and his elbow. If his elbow goes inside my knee, boom, now we're going to start all over again. Do I get the elbow inside? So my foot is connected. There's no space. You feel how there's no space between my shin? You see? We're stuck. And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make that go forward enough so I can use my other foot to replace. When do I replace? Light? Green light. So if you feel his elbow moving, go, get it in, up, go, at some point he's going to go inside, pick it up. So the battle is going to be what I call top to bottom. Using your shin across his thigh. Now sometimes he's pretty tight, so I might need to lever back, lean back, and drive my shin into his leg. Sometimes what happens is that as my knee is coming here, his elbow starts to go that way. Then it's like more, like not so much that way, but a lot of times you do that, right? So as I'm doing this, you kind of keep your elbow. Yes, that starts happening. Freeze. Now, you notice there's space now from up to the wing. So you can't overcommit and overdefend by coming across his body. You understand what I mean? Like across his body. He can only come in so tight. But once his elbow starts to glide across the body, it allows space for your hook. So he becomes overly committed and overly distracted in defending this. And now I'm going to bring my foot to the inside, which is exactly what I was trying to do from the very beginning. But he wasn't letting me from here because he was keeping his elbow tight. But once I go high up on his knee and I start to go across, it starts to guide his elbow that way. Boom, hooks it. Now, I don't care how you do it. Get the hook in. Grab a partner, and we're only going to try to get the hooks in this way. If you get them in, you get them in. Then I'm also going to show you a second and a third option to get the hooks in. But I want you to start just solely developing this one way. If you have another way, I don't care. Do it. Grab a partner. And grab a partner. Don't circle up just yet. Grab a partner. I want you guys to go one, maybe two rounds and just trying to do it this specific way. And then come back and say, what are the problems? And we start deploying the goals.
Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching my video. Please click like and subscribe to my channel for more great strike-based jiu-jitsu content. If you have any questions about the techniques that I'm demonstrating, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much.